Vice Chairman, Niti Aayog, Dr. Rajiv Kumarji, Secretary Department of Biotechnology, Dr. Renu Swaroopji, members of the Atal Innovation Mission and Atal Tinkering Lab teams. Ladies and gentlemen, dear children, at the outset, let me extend my greetings to all of you. Today is a great day for you. Today is Children's Day. And after interacting with you and seeing your innovative ideas, I feel a little bit jealous of you all. Because unfortunately, I could not have all these facilities when I was a student in my village. And you are fortunate enough to get so many facilities, so many ideas, so many good teachers, and so many good mentors. But as of now, you all are a part of the AIM, that is Atal Innovation Mission. And what should be your aim in life? You have now to take a call. I will not say what should be, but in the long run, as the things materialize in due course of time, I think your aim should be to make the people's living easy living. That is known as ease of living, whatever we can do. And in fact, there is no difference in yourself and myself. I am also doing the same job. I am also trying and making my efforts at my level to make our people, our citizens of the country, to be most happiest persons, to most developed. Now, for that reason, I think I would appeal to all of you, please don't leave your aim in between. Whatever difficulties you will face, but it is but natural. With the passage of time, you will face some problems from the society, from the community, from your relatives, even from your parents. But here I will also like to make a suggestion to the team that you please take care of this team, that in future, as Rajivji had said, you try to make them as best scientists as they can. Now, I wish you a warm welcome to Rashtrapati Bhavan. Today is a special day for children around the country. And it is also a special day for me, since I meet and interact with children from across the country. One team has come all the way from Kochi, from Gaya, from Bilaspur in Chhattisgarh, and Tamil Nadu. So it's a brief picture of mini India that way. So I feel happy to be meeting all of you. But all of you are here not just because you are children, but because you are some of the most promising student innovators in our country. I am told that you were selected as the best innovators from approximately 50,000 students from 2,700 schools across the country. This is a remarkable achievement. I was just impressed to see your exhibits just now, and it makes me wonder what young children of this nation can achieve when given the opportunity to think unconventionally. I am also filled with hope. We may be facing difficult challenges in the world today, but we also have young people like you willing to think differently to find the solutions to these problems. The voyage for all of you has truly been a marathon. You had to cross multiple levels of selection, and in the end, you were also put through a 10-week long student innovator program. At the end of this marathon, as you cross the finishing line today, you should feel proud of yourselves. All your hard work and perseverance has earned you this recognition. While you savor your success, I want you to remember that you have also now been given an opportunity. An opportunity to convert your prototypes into viable products and eventually into a startup. So in a sense, your marathon may have ended, but your journey has only just begun. All this would not have been possible for you without your families and friends who have supported you at every single step. You must also not forget the role played by your teachers and mentors. They have been the GPS of your voice. In one of the exhibits, I have witnessed the use of GPS for the blind persons. They have provided you with guidance, planning, and stimulation for you to traverse this path. From students, they have transformed you into young innovators. I am happy that some of your mentors are here with you today in your moment of success. Dear children, you come from different states, speak different languages, and have grown up in different cultures. Yet, a common cause has united all of us: to find innovative solutions to problems faced by our society. But you won't find these answers alone by yourselves. You will have to learn to work with others, appreciate each other's ideas, and understand different points of views. You have seen how thinking differently can be rewarding, but you should also remember that unless you work together, you will not be able to see your ideas bear fruit. As young innovators, I would like you to keep in mind one more thing. Be sensitive to the needs of those less fortunate than you. When you select the problems you wish to address or the solutions you devise, ask yourselves if it can help disadvantaged people like the differently abled or children in need. To progress as a society, we have to move forward together and ensure that no one gets left behind. Ladies and gentlemen and children, over the past few years, I have been speaking about the importance of innovation and developing a culture of innovation. We have been hosting a festival of innovation and entrepreneurship at Rashtrapati Bhavan in collaboration with the Department of Science and Technology, and this year we took the festival to the people. In March, I inaugurated this festival at Gandhinagar in Gujarat. Speaking at the function, I had emphasized that we need schools where children tinker rather than memorize and mug. We need work cultures where young talent looks up and questions rather than looks down and nods. And we need the government to provide a facilitative environment. In this context, I am happy to see the work done by Atal Innovation Mission and the team at Atal Tinkering Lab. I am told that you selected the top 50 teams and worked rigorously with them in 15 Atal Incubation Centers, where these students spend an entire week immersed in various aspects of business development. This is indeed commendable. We need to provide an ecosystem where the innovations that these young minds come up with can be nurtured. By encouraging children to tinker and innovate, we are fostering a generation who will be self-reliant and resourceful, a generation that will be job creators and not job seekers. I hope to see these young boys and girls one day as successful entrepreneurs And for that, Atal Innovation Mission will have to remain engaged with them continuously, hand-holding them through their path ahead. I convey my best wishes to the children whom I met today, their mentors, and the entire Atal Innovation family. I am sure you will carry on this good work and continue holding more such tinkering marathons in the future. Thank you. Jai Hind.